Brazil's amazing. We just got here. I already took a nap for like 2 hours and it felt amazing. Yeah. Right after we got done with our first audition, we got off stage and we're immediately like, oh my God, we did it. We did it. We proved what we needed to prove to like our friends and everyone. We got 4 yeses. And that at that moment, I honestly did feel like, dude, this could be something big.
We felt like superstars after that. We were like,
performing covers on the X Factor was pretty difficult for us. I mean, ever since I was 9, he was like 12 or 13, he was 11, we were all writing and performing our own songs. So It was kind of difficult, but it was kind of a way to expand our comfort zone, because the only way to expand your comfort zone is to step out, and we did that. And anytime you feel the pain, hey, just refrain. Don't carry the world up on your shoulder. It feels good to see a lot of the other contestants on X Factor like killing it in the industry right now. And that's because when we see them doing good, we know that we're going to do good too. That's what's cool about the X Factor, is that like if you do good on that show and you play your cards right, and you can do good in the industry itself. So I love my women like I love my juice. Naked, all natural, no preservatives and fakeness. I like my ladies like I like my Brady's in bunches. Got the six pack, I ain't talking about the crunches. Yeah, when we were recording the album, we were listening to all sorts of music, like Imagine Dragons, and then like complete indie bands that no one has ever heard of, and then of course like classics like Sublime and Dirty Heads and just all these other great bands.
We listen to everything, like any style, so like it varies from like Wiz Khalifa hip hop to like City and Color. I know that we're taking
chances. So far we've got it's been pretty good. We got number one in Brazil, the album went, which was like, yeah, we love you guys.
You, te amo.
More than like the charts and stuff like that, which we got to number one in America and a lot of other countries and stuff, which was like huge for us. We're just like some small town dudes and
regular guys, like.
Yeah, it was crazy. But like more than that is like our friends and our family are like, yo, that album's sick. Like you guys like, we can feel the heart in it. And like that's what means that means more than any of the charts or anything. It's just knowing that our friends think it's dope. So that's what's cool. I'm giving you the X's, X's. I'm giving you the O's. I'm giving you everything. I think honestly, I love all the songs on the album. Like each one I can remember specifically recording it and spending the time on thinking of the lyrics and the melodies and recording that. And it takes me back to that time in the studio, because when we were in the studio, like, we were just having fun, you know? It's just, we're all like best friends, so we're just hanging out, goofing around, having fun, and make, like, the most important part is having fun, and then the second thing is like making the album. So any of the songs just take me back to a happy place, I guess.
Every time I listen to 3,000 Miles, I get that feeling like in my heart. It literally makes me want to cry, because I cried on stage actually after performing that song, or during performing that song.
Favorite song to play live is 3,000 Miles, because like that's like the lighter or phone in the air moment when everyone's like going like this, and it looks so beautiful from the stage. It's like thousands of people, a sea of lights. It's like crazy.
It's like a sea of jellyfish or stars floating in front of your face, but when you think about it, it's actually thousands of people out there watching you, and it's amazing. It's truly amazing.
Hardest thing for me is leaving all friends and family, because we literally have like the best group of friends back home that just surround us with so much love, and our family is just always supporting us and like just feeding us love and stuff. And like to leave that is like so hard, because we feed off that. We use it to, you know, motivate us, and it's hard to not have that around all the time.
If only you could believe in yourself in the way I believe in you, I do.
For me, it was actually going to high school like a normal kid. And because now I don't get to experience some of the stuff. And then, of course, going into college, I would have liked to do that. But it's okay. I mean, my life is still pretty awesome right now.
My God, amazing that we got this far. It's like we're chasing all the stars.
We all, like, really miss our friends and family and stuff. But the girlfriend situation just doesn't work out when you're constantly traveling. So it's like, I really want a girlfriend or like, you know, someone like that, but you're moving so often that you can't have any like relationships with anyone, and that can get frustrating. But that's just right now, you know. This is all just like this temporary roller coaster ride that we're on, and it's super fun, so we're not complaining by any means. Like, we enjoy every single day, but like, it'd be nice to, you know, have a lady.
Can I just say that I really like your nose ring?
Traveling around the world, doing what we love, is literally the coolest thing ever.
Basically, the feeling that you get when you're traveling around the world playing music, doing what you love with your best friends, is the same feeling that you get when your dreams come true.
What they can expect from us for this show is a lot of fun. And, I don't know. It's just going to be so much fun. I'm so excited. And no, wait. I expect them to jump around and have a lot of fun.
When we go out on stage, especially in Brazil, we've basically made our minds up that this is going to be the craziest show that we've ever played. And we just go out and we give all the energy that we possibly have stored up in these bodies. And hopefully the audience will reciprocate that energy back to us. And I figure, since we're in Brazil and they have such like a reputation about being so passionate about stuff like that, that's gonna happen.
We're just gonna go out there, have tons of energy, give a lot of love, and hopefully receive a lot of love. And it's gonna be a big love fest. It's gonna be amazing.
Well, we're actually performing with Boyce Avenue, which they're actually our friends from the X Factor. They were our vocal coaches, and it's going to be really cool to see them again and hang out with them and watch their show.
Lay down and come alive and all you found, all you're meant to be. Sexy little dress, but it's still
That's awesome. Not gonna lie, I'm actually surprised. It sounds really good. It's really cool. It all looks good to me, but I love P9, what's up? We'll see you there. It's gonna be fun.
Hey, it's Ayamo.